JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, the life of Christopher Dog Paul Linton. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items. A reputed gangster and at one time Jamaica's most wanted man, Christopher Dog Paul Linton reigned as the leader of Jamaica's criminal underworld for more than a decade. Months before he was cut down in an alleged firefight with the police on Monday, the days appeared to be numbered for the reputed gangster as the noose tightened around his inner circle of cronies who sought to resurrect his reign of notoriety and bloodlust. One of Linton's loyalists, Romaine Richards, otherwise called Diddy, described as his right hand, was shot and killed in Kintyre by rival gangsters on Tuesday, August 10, and was buried on the weekend. It was a signal of the beginning of the end for the once feared crime lord, whose clenched fist and angry threats had long lost the power of persuasion in a spiraling war for turf, authority, and respect. A former schoolmate of Linton, who spoke on condition of anonymity, said that he had paraded the moniker Dog Paw from they were in 7th grade and had a history of violence and gang running. He passed a Jamaica College and immediately was hugely famous among the school population from running a gang among his peers. He didn't stay long at JC, said Linton's schoolmate. He was expelled and then attended Dunoon, where the badness reputation followed him. He was expelled from there also. After his teenage incubation in violence, Linton later filled the vacuum left by incarcerated gangster Joel Andem, who is serving a 20-year sentence for firearm and shooting convictions. Andem's fall led to the rise of Linton, who emerged as a force in the underworld, unleashing violence on the eastern St. Andrew neighborhoods of Lanlease, Mudtown, Kintyre, Papin, and Augustown. Said to have operated a successful extortion ring, he was considered intelligent and was revered by his cronies. It is believed that throughout his criminal career, Dog Paul masterminded many violent undertakings and a boatload of gang activities that made him one of the most feared men in the St. Andrew area. But as his notoriety grew, so did the police's interest in him. Dog Paul kept popping up on the police's radar, especially after he was accused of leading an attack in Bedford Gardens in Kingston that involved 50 men spraying a house with bullets, then burning it down, leaving a family of three dead. The deceased were identified as 50-year-old Maurice Hilton, 31-year-old Diana Forbes, and her 6-year-old son, Jermaine McKay. The gruesome ordeal led a very determined police force in search of Linton. Law enforcers at one point even offered $250,000 to anyone who could assist them in finding Linton. It was during this manhunt back in 2011 that Dog Paul reportedly pinned messages to the police expressing his innocence and that he feared for his life. The police, however, sent back messages letting Linton know that he could turn himself in without worrying about his safety. Reports are that Dog Paul was found at a house in Elliston Flats and an illegal 9mm pistol was also found. It was reportedly found in the company of a popular uptown socialite. He then found his way into the bowels of the Jamaican justice system. In 2012, Linton was freed of a gun-related charge, but in February 2013, Linton and a co-accused, Michael Allen, were convicted on other gun-related charges in the High Court. Linton and Allen were convicted for shooting at two police officers who were traveling in a service vehicle along Tavern Drive, St. Andrew, in April 2010. In 2017, the trial against Linton and two other men accused of the gruesome triple murder in Bedford Gardens, St. Andrew, that initially put him on the police radar, collapsed. Linton's two co-accused, Yannick Ellis and Donald Allen, were freed after prosecutors told a judge in the Home Circuit Court that they were discontinuing the trial against them, subject to the availability of witnesses. Linton and his co-accused had been in custody since 2010 when they were charged with killing 50-year-old Maurice Hilton, 31-year-old Diana Forbes, and their 6-year-old son Jaheim McKay in Bedford Gardens. In April 2021, the reputed gang leader's conviction was quashed in the Court of Appeal after spending more than 7 years behind bars. Linton had been serving a 15-year sentence on a conviction for a 2012 case of shooting at the police. is co-convict in the case. Michael Allen was also freed by the appeal court.
Freedom is a must. I'm just grateful for that. Tomorrow.
Head of the Crime and Security Portfolio, Deputy Commissioner of Police Fitz Bailey, said that since his release, Linton has been implicated in several murders and shootings.
Since his release from prison in April of this year, he has been implicated in several shootings and murder within the Elliston Flat Tavern area of St. Andrew. The matter is being investigated by Indicom. As a consequence, I will not say much more.
In June 2021, the police said Linton was among a group of four men shot by unknown assailants in the Cane River area of Bull Bay. Linton, who was shot in the upper body, had claimed that he had been shot in tavern, but the police did not believe his account. He finally met his end at the hands of lawmen on October 11, 2021. He was killed shortly before 2 p.m. Officers acting on information said they intercepted a vehicle in which armed men were believed to be traveling in Elliston Flats, St. Andrew. Upon arrival, the lawmen commanded that the vehicle stop. Police reports say Linton alighted from the vehicle, opening fire at the police. The gunfire was returned and Linton was shot. He was taken to a nearby medical facility where he succumbed to his injuries. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.